We're just wrapping it up over here, man. We're talking it up.
We got
having a blast. You know, Charlie?
We met in Kansas City. Good to see you again, man.
Good to see you again, too.
Yeah. This is our, you know, our North Central Barista champion. He's a regional champ. It was a good win for him. He's an educator with Intelligentsia Coffee at the original Chicago Broadway location. He's been around a bit, man. You know, for such a young man, for such an enthused man, you know, you've done a lot in your career. You know, so who here knows Charlie Habiger?
Woo!
Myself on that one up. I don't even know. They're ready. All right, come on, Tim. Come on, judges. I'm going to just get out of the way because this is the semifinals and you're ready to go.
Hey, it's you. Hey, thanks. Hi, nice to meet you.
Hello.
Hi. Hey, Jess. Hello. Hi, how are you?
Okay, so start button's where it's at.
Okay.
15 minutes awaits. I wish you the best of luck. Let's put your hands together, please, for Charlie Habiger from Intelligentsia Coffee in Chicago, Illinois.
So this is going to sound a little bit juvenile, but I've had the experience a few different times in my life where I pick up some living thing. This could be like a leaf, it could be a bug. I've even done this with the palm of my own hand, where as I look closer and closer, there's always a moment where I realize that it's actually more than just a single thing, right? There's all this complexity, there's all this variety underneath the surface that I didn't realize before I really took a good look. Because no biological thing is monolithic, right? It's actually a complex series of systems that are different, but they work together to make something that makes sense. So I work with coffee a lot. Coffee, to me, is a living thing. I have this experience a lot with coffee, where the closer I look, the less single of an anything a coffee seems to be, because the more variety I'm aware of. So the coffee that I brought today that I'm going to serve is, I think, a delicious example of how variety that's inherent to coffee production, also coffee sourcing, can be used to the benefit of great taste and amazing character. So I'm going to start talking about it from the outside in, and maybe as I get a little bit closer, you guys will have a better idea of what I'm trying to say. So the coffee's from Colombia, first and foremost. Colombia has 37 different departments. We call these regions for buying purposes. There's one particular department called Huila, which is very well known. Lots of award-winning coffees have come out of Huila in the last 10 years. The department of Huila itself can be further subdivided into 37 different municipalities. That's all within the same department. There's one municipality that's called San Agustin. So we're getting pretty specific. But the closer I study this coffee, eventually I realized that within San Agustin, the coffee actually came from multiple farms. And not only that, but there were multiple lots from within these multiple farms that were separated and then combined in a very specific way to make this coffee, which is really interesting. How does this happen? So the answer is a process called lot building. And I have a quick visualization for you guys before I start on the first course. I want you to look into the bowl and imagine as if in the bowl, all of the different items that you see represent flavors that you might find if you were to cup lot for lot from a very small production region. So there's lots of variety. Well, lot building is this process where exporters, importers, buyers, roasters, whomever is responsible can literally deconstruct the produce from even a very small area and build a lot of coffee by combining these lots together, like so, and come up with something that is not only delicious, but exemplary of the best that this little particular production region has to offer. So my coffee was created this way, and the espresso that I'm going to serve tastes a lot like what you see in the glass. So it's blackberry aromatics throughout, especially up front. I'm using some white chocolate to evoke what to me is like a lemon curd or a lemon marmalade, vanilla bean, and then a really clean, crisp finish that reminds me a lot of basil. So that's what's at the bottom. I'm just going to put this over here, and I'll be serving your espressos first, so make yourselves comfortable, and I'll be right back with those. Thanks, guys. Okay, so I'm going to purge here. Thank you.
Okay.
So while the shots are cooling, I just want to remind you guys that you have flavor notes represented in the glass. Also, look for low viscosity in the body. It's going to be very bright throughout, but very delicate and balanced. So this is it, San Agustin. The receptacles in front of your plates will be for your spoons. Please enjoy the shots. See you next. Thanks a lot, guys.
Espressos from Charlie.
Cappuccinos. Cappuccinos are delicious. They taste great. They're also a great test for a coffee, for a coffee's resilience. Well-produced coffees, well-built coffees also are very versatile. You can pull them different ways, and you can pair them with different things, and their character still shines through. So these caps, you taste much more vanilla custard, lemon cookie. So the flavors are simpler, but they're still really delicious. You. Thanks so much, guys. Enjoy. Same receptacle for the spoons. Gentlemen, I'll be right back.
Cappuccinos 1 and 2.
Cappuccino is really straightforward. Vanilla custard, lemon cookie. Thank you. Same receptacle for your spoons. After the last cap is down, I'm going to give you guys some more water and also move some other things to the table to start the signature drink. So I'll give you a moment to write, and then I'll be back with a whole new table and a little bit more to say. You're welcome.
I'm sure Charlie's got a lot more to say, but there's his cappuccinos, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for him.
Mm-hmm. All right, final course. For the signature drink, what I wanted to do was, pardon me, use the same type of process that created my coffee to work out your drink for you.
Thank you.
It occurred to me when I was building the drink that the process of making a signature drink is a lot like the process of lot building, where you want high quality ingredients, you want them to be complementary to one another, you want them to be consistent, and you want the overall product to have a good sense of time and place. So I'm actually going to use ingredients from your bowls to construct the drink. I'm going to start by taking a vanilla bean. Thanks. And I'm going to split it. Like that. And I'm going to add this to some water that I've had simmering in the back. Next, what I did was I took some blackberries. Pardon me. Thanks. And also some basil. Thank you, miss. And I put these together and I made a jam. I wanted flavors to come from the espresso, but I also wanted to enrich the drink a little bit. So I wanted that the viscosity of the jam and the sweetness, which I have right here. To each of your glasses, I'm going to add 10 grams of the blackberry basil jam. Just like that. I'm going to pull shots of the San Agustin into the jam and bring your board back and finish the drink for you.